Today we're going to look at the FX9750G3 graphing calculator, and we're just going to explore the layout and the buttons to give you a sense of what each does. And then in a continuing series, you're going to be looking at specific menu items where you can see how the different buttons interact within those menus. So right now, this video is just to kind of make sure you understand the layout and what the buttons are on the screen and how they impact what you're doing. So this is the calculator. This is the emulator software. And you'll notice it's a menu-driven calculator. So this is the menu right here. And this is kind of the standard form when you get through here. So the button that controls your navigation through the window is this scroll button right here. So this is your up, your down, right, left. So this is how you navigate through the menus to decide which function, which menu icon you want to go into. So you can use the scroll bar to get to where you want, or if you notice, each menu item has a little number, or after we've run out of our numbers, we go into the alphabet, a letter, and you can choose that to get directly to where you want to go. So if I know I want to go into table, I can scroll to the table, or I can just hit 7 and it will open the table for me. When you're in a menu icon, so I just put myself into the table menu icon and I want to get back to the menu, this button right here called menu will get you back. So that's pretty easy. So navigating through the menu items is using the scroll bar or using the numbers or letters at the bottom of a specific menu icon. Once you're in a menu, so it doesn't matter which menu you go to. So I just am going to choose this first one, which is where you would do your calculations. You hit execute to get into that menu. So execute is, think of it like an equal sign on other calculators, but it is basically how you set things or choose something. So I'm choosing that menu, I'm hitting execute, it lets me in. So I want to talk about these buttons at the top across the calculator. These are your function buttons, and these function buttons control what you do once you're in a menu icon. So basically you want to line up the function with the words that are across the top or the bottom of the display screen. So whatever menu you happen to be in, these are going to be different, obviously, but the functions control what goes in there. So jump is over F1, and jump in this case is letting me jump around on my screen. This will take me to a matrix. So let's just show you what that means. So basically you follow the functions underneath the words that are in the display. So F3 will control this matrix. If I choose F3, it takes me to a matrix. So now notice I'm in a different section of the run matrix, and now I have different choices here. And again, the functions underneath will let you see the action that's going on here. So again, if I wanted to change the dimensions of a matrix, it's dimensions under F3, so I would now be able to set up my dimensions. Whenever you're in a menu and you want to get back to the screen before or back to the home screen, this button on the calculator called exit will help you get there. So you're going to hit exit and it takes you back to the previous screen. If you want to go all the way back, you keep hitting exit. So exit's how you basically get back to where you were before, and it'll bring you back. And once you're there, you can then hit menu, and now you're ready to go to a different icon. So the function buttons right here control what you see at the bottom of a display, no matter what menu icon you've chosen. So if I were to go and choose conics this time, choose 9, here's my conic options, and notice I can now use F1 for rectangular, F2 for polar, and F3 for parametric. So again, the functions control movement within a menu, which is really nice because a Casio calculator, you don't have to hunt around here for where is that thing that I want. It's always going to be in the menu icon itself, controlled by these movements with the functions. Okay, so everything you need for that specific menu that you're in is going to be right here on the screen, and your functions will control it. Let's hit menu and get back, and let's just talk about some of these other options here. You'll notice above a lot of the buttons on the calculator, there are things that are in yellow and there are things that are in red. That means that they have a second option here using this function. So for example, if we look above all the function keys, we can trace, zoom, view window, sketch, solve, and I don't remember what that one is. So each one of these buttons means I have to hit the shift. Notice the shift button is yellow to make them happen. So for example, view window, that happens when I'm in, say, a graph. So let's just go to the graph window. And if I want to see the size of my window, I want to go to the view window. So notice right now, if I hit the function F3, it's going to let me choose the type of graph I want. If I want to look at the view window, I want to hit shift button first, then F3. And now I can change the window before I graph. So anything in yellow. So notice that there's quite a few things in yellow that you push the button and it will control this. So for example, if we just look at the buttons in general here, this is how you enter x squared, how you square a variable here. You use this button. If you want a square root, you're gonna hit shift, then that button. Here's where you can, this button will allow you to do powers. So to the third power, to the fourth power. If you want to do the root, cubic roots, quadratic roots, you would hit the shift first. If you want to do theta, you're going to hit the alpha or the red button first. So the buttons have multiple purposes depending on what you need, and the color determines what it might be. So for example here, if I were to hit alpha x squared button, because I hit the red first, this is going to give me an R value, or an R variable rather. So same thing here. This is how I get powers of 10, e to the x, all in yellow. If I want to type words, so if you're writing programs or you're trying to maybe label a statistics column and you want letters, you're going to hit the alpha and then the red, the buttons here that have the different alphabets. So you'll see that alphabets go all the way up to Z, in fact. So you just hit red beforehand, or you can lock the alpha button. Notice above the alpha button, it's in yellow. And if you want to lock it so that every button you push is going to just be the letter, you can hit shift alpha. So that's what shift and that's what alpha do. They let you access the yellow functions or the red functions, depending. These buttons down here, we've already explained what this is and what this one is. Exit is controlling how you get back in the screens within a menu. These are your typical math functions, right? So log, natural log, sine, cosine, tan. So your trig functions there. This, and let's actually hit exit. Let's go back to menu and go up to run. This button right here determines you can enter a rational number or a mixed number. So if I wanted to enter, I don't know, 7/8, I could hit the button first and type in and use my scroll bar to go down to the denominator, or I could do it, hit my first number, then hit the template, and then hit the second number. Either way, it works. And if you wanted this mixed number, you would have to hit the yellow first and then this button. So then you just would use your scroll bar to put the numbers in the correct position. This right here, standard form, which is this form right here, rational to decimal. It's just a toggle back and forth. Same thing here. This will toggle if you hit shift first. It'll toggle between a mixed number and an improper fraction. So again, that's what that button does here. These are pretty self-evident. Parentheses, commas. This is a quick button to store something. So if you've done a calculation and you want to store it, if you've created a matrix and you want to store it, then this button will help you store things. So if we go around here, delete, obvious, it will delete the last thing that you did. So I just hit delete and it did that. I can't turn off the emulator, but on a handheld calculator, if you wanted to turn off the calculator and you're done, notice off is up here, so that means I have to hit shift and then the all clear button. So this button right here clears your screen of things that you did, or it clears everything, not just one. Delete will clear one thing at a time, all clear will clear everything in that line, and off will turn it off, obviously. Catalog, this will actually take you to the catalog for Casio. We're not going to do that, but well, I'll show you what it does. When you hit shift, it brings you to the You know, what do all of these symbols mean? Kind of. So if you're programming, this is really important. When you're programming, you don't want to have to type something out. You can find quick things, and you can search by alphabet. So if I wanted to do, let's just go to, I don't know, the N's and hit execute. It's going to bring that up. Okay. So list right here, if I need the word list, this is how I would get it. So shift list puts that word list in there. If I need the word matrix in there, let's say I have several matrices, A, B, C already defined, and I now want to use them in a calculation. So I use the word shift matrix, and then I can put in whatever matrix I want to use. So now this is matrix A. So that's what that's for. Now, obviously, that doesn't make any sense because I don't have any thing in there. The rest of the buttons are pretty. This is where you do scientific notation. Notice this is where you can get the pi symbol in there. Spacing, again, a lot of this has to do with programming. If you're typing things in, if you're creating programs where you need commas and parentheses and quotations, those types of things, that's what a lot of this is for. Most of the buttons, if you're just doing your regular calculation, not necessarily programming, are going to be up here in the functions when you're in a menu. And the yellow buttons above. One thing I do want to point out is another button right here that we have not talked about, which is the option button. So I'm going to hit menu again, and it doesn't matter what menu icon I'm in. So I'm going to hit stats this time. And stats, again, here's my functions that control what I see. Notice up here there's this arrow. If I hit F6, that just means there's more to see. So these functions give me movement within a menu. Whatever menu I am in, I always want to check option. So when I'm in a menu, so we're in statistics, I hit options. Options, there's even more to see. So basically, you're going to scroll through using the functions, and then options gives you more things to look at. So let's just look at another menu item to show you what I mean. Let's go to equation solving, right? So here's equation solving. If I hit options, there's nothing, right? So that was probably a bad example. Let's pick another one. Let's do graph. There we go. Graph. And if I choose option now, notice I have some different options that I can use, different types of graphs. So basically, when you're in a menu, the functions control movement within the menu and what you can do. So different options, you know, different variables, different functions, different, you know, probability versus calculations that you can do. Options gives you more things within that menu icon, right? So your movement is always with the function buttons. Options gives you more options to move through, is how we're looking at this. This right here is the variables button, and this actually will recall things that you have stored as variables. So it lets you see the view window, what was the latest thing stored. So if I hit that one right now, it will simply tell me what the current view of X is. So if I hit X, it's going to tell me what I set up in the window as the minimum, which was whatever the X minimum was if I hit execute. So this is just recalling anything that you've stored, anything that you've used. That's what that variable button will do. Just bring it up for you if you need it. If you need that X min in a calculation, or you need to just check what it is, that's what this will do for you. This is just a quick overview of the buttons, and we are going to have a continuing series. We're going to look at specific menus and explain what's within each menu. So we're going to look at run matrix and statistics, specific menus, and go through all the options that are controlled by these functions and the option button here.